A few days ago, I was watching this video from Gary Simon at designcourse.com where he is designing texturized colorful backgrounds for UI. He is explaining how to use Photoshop to design a light version and a dark version of it. And I was wondering how difficult or how easy it would be to design such a background with OxyProps and Oxygen. And this is exactly what we are going to do today. And as you can see, my three-year-old already gave me the wireframe for this design. So let's jump right into Oxygen and design it together. And here we are in a brand new Oxygen page. Just before we start, let's have a look at what we want to achieve. This is my version of the design, very similar to Gary Simon's one. We have a menu bar at the top, a hero section with a title, a subtitle, a graphic here, and this design element here. And the main purpose of this is this colored and textured background. We have this splash of color here and another one here. Maybe you can notice that they are slightly moving. This one is slightly contracting and this one is moving up and down. We also use OxyProps light and dark mode toggle. So here, if I click, I will switch to dark mode. You can notice that the background changes, but also my logo changes, my text changes, my graphic here changes, and I can come back to light mode. Okay, you like it? So let's start building that together. And we are back in Oxygen. I have my structure panel open so you can see what happens. And to start with, let's add a header builder. And in my header builder, I'll use the first row and first I'll add my logo. My logo is an SVG I got from Logo Ipsum. So I'll add a code block to add directly the SVG code inline. Just to let you know, I cleaned the code a little so I can use it. Just a few things to let you know that are important. I removed all inline style directly inside the SVG. You often find either stroke colors or fill colors. I removed it. And I also made sure that I have my view box defined and also a width set to 100%, which is important so that my SVG resizes with its parent container. I will apply code. Maybe it's difficult on the video to see it, but it appeared here and it's black. It's black, that's normal because I have removed stroke and fills. So by default, it's black. So first thing I will do is that I will use OxyProps specific SVG class to add fill, and I will add the class fill and I will use my text one color for my logo. Here we are. I will also make sure that we have no stroke. So I use the class NoStroke. So we have only a fill color and no stroke. I can collapse the editor. So here we are with the logo. I will set its width and I will use a fluid size of 7. Here we are. And I will also add a bit of padding to the header and I will use block padding. If you don't know about block padding, that's a logical property for CSS. We have block padding and inline padding. Block padding is top and bottom. Inline padding is left and right, which is valid for left to right languages. So I will add the class opadBL for block, and I will add a padding of 2. Here we are. And now I have my logo defined. Let's take care of the rest of the menu. I will add my light and dark toggle and I will drag it to the right. As you can see, the canvas color switched to light mode because this component uses local storage to store user preferences. And just before, when I made the demonstration, I left it in the light mode state. So my browser remembers that I prefer light mode. That's why it automatically switched to light mode. Let's add some navigation links. I will add text links. Here we are. Reorder it. This will be my account. And as I want to organize it, and that in Oxygen it's not possible to style directly the row right part, I will wrap it in a div, add my toggle, okay, and duplicate the link. My div will be an horizontal flexbox and I will add a gap, let's say a gap of 4. And here we are. We have this even spacing between the links, and this one will be home, trainings, and here we are. And to finish, I will set my menu to overlay always. Next, let's add a section. My section will be 100 viewport height, so full viewport height. And now let's add a heading. Let's add some text. My heading will be a brighter future today. Let's make it font size 3, and I want it even bigger, so I will multiply it. Okay, I want to limit the width of my heading, so I will choose 15 cm. Perfect. My text, I want it a size 3.2. Perfect. A weight of 200. Nice. I want to add a little of vertical spacing to my section, so I will choose a gap of 4, and I will add padding to the top, and I will go to a padding of 8. Perfect. Now let's go and design this icon. This is an SVG and it's a simple one, so we will create it from scratch. So let's add a code block. Let's get rid of that and we will create our SVG. It's very simple. As you can see, that's a rectangle with rounded corners and a circle. So let's create that. We have an SVG with a view box of 0, 0, 102, 152. If you're not familiar with SVGs, the view box defines the coordinates of the window and you look at your SVG design through this window. So 0, 0 is the top left corner and 102, 152 is the bottom right corner. So here we have defined a window that is 102 units width and 152 units tall. Actually, my mistake, I don't want it to be 102, I want it to be 52 because my rectangle will be 50 by 150. So now let's create our rectangle. So that's very easy. I create a rect for a rectangle and I will define the coordinates of the top left corner. X is 1, Y is 1. Okay. Its width is 50. Its height is 150. Radiuses are X. I want it fully rounded. So as my width is 50, the radius will be 25 and the other one is also 25. I want my rectangle to be outlined, so I will define a stroke width of 1, and as I want no fill, I will specify a fill of none, and my rectangle is defined. Just to show you, I will close my SVG, self-close the rectangle tag, and apply code. We see the box appear, but we see no fill, and this is because by default my fill is defined to none. I haven't defined any stroke, so I will add my stroke text 1 to match my text color to my code block, and we should see, here it is, we should see our rounded rectangle appear. Perfect. That's exactly what we wanted to achieve. Now let's add the circle. So when you create a circle, you first give the center coordinates. So the X coordinate is 26. The Y coordinate is also 26. And I will make sure I don't forget the equal signs. The radius is 20. And on the circle, I want only fill, no stroke. So I will say stroke equals none. Self-close the tag and let's apply the code, and we can see our circle appearing, and I will make sure that the fill match my text color, because now by default, as nothing is specified, it's black. So I will add the class OFillText1 is suggested by Oxygen here, and here we are, and we are done. If I want to be able to control the dimensions of my SVG, I need to add as I said earlier, a width of 100%, I apply, and now I can define a width for my container. Let's say I want a size 4, and my SVG will adapt. If I want to enlarge it, okay, so let's come back to 4, that's nice. Okay, let's save, Command S on a Mac. We are in Oxygen 4 RC1, and we have a keyboard shortcut to save our progress, which is a very nice improvement. Let's go and see what it looks like on the front end. And here we are, and we can check that our light and dark toggle is working perfectly. Back to Oxygen. Last thing before we work on the background, let's add this graphic element, and that will be an image. Let's pick up this one from my media library. Perfect. This will be absolutely positioned with a bottom of 0 and a right of 0. And let's make sure that our section is positioned relative. So the image is positioned relative to the section. Let's save. Just check the front end, refresh. Here we are. Okay, let's continue and get our structure panel back. And back to my section, I want to add those graphic elements. And for that, I will first add a div. And this div will be my blob number 1. And let's start styling it. And I wanted to have a gradient background. Let's choose this one, colorful one. I will set my background size to cover, and I will also add some noise, a noise of 3. So if we look, I don't know if you see on the video, but there is some noise now with my gradient. It's more, let's enlarge it and let's give it a width of 5/6 of viewport width, and a height of 2/3. Okay, since bigger, I hope you can see that we have this noise here now in the background. And let's shape it. Let's go to the borders and add maybe a blob 2. Okay, let's try this one, or maybe a blob 3. 1. I'll stick with 2. Okay, now I will position my blob and I will give it an absolute positioning, and let's say that we will be -10% on top and -15% on the left. Let's change the z-index to -1. Perfect. And now we want this to be much less visible, so let's play with Oxygen filters. First, we will add a blur 60 pixels, perfect. And let's play with opacity and change the opacity to 0.4. Nice. Let's create a second blob. So I will duplicate this one. I will change the positioning. It will be a right and bottom of maybe 15% and 5%, maybe 10. Let's reduce the dimensions, a width of 1/2 the viewport width, and a height of 1/3 of the viewport height. Here it is. Perfect. So we have now our two color bubbles. And let's say that we want to animate them. This one, by the way, is my blob too. Okay. So this one, maybe I want it to contract and expand. So I will add, and let's add it to the proper element. So let's make sure I choose my blob 1, and I want to add my pulse animation class, and you can see it moving. And the second one, let's add a float animation, and now you can see it moving up and down. Maybe it's a bit fast, so let's change this. And as there is nowhere in the Oxygen properties panel to define the animation duration, we will have to go to the custom CSS and define an animation duration of, let's say, 10 seconds for this one. Apply, and let's go to the second one. Make sure I have the ID selected, custom CSS, and let's set the duration to 7 seconds. Apply code, collapse, let's save, and let's have a look at our front end. Refresh. And it looks like we are done. We have our dark version. We can see the first blob that is moving, contracting and expanding. And we can see this one that is moving also up and down slowly. Let's check the light version. And here it is, dark, light. And as you can see, as I did use for my logo here and for my SVG here, OxyProps logical colors, I use the text one logical color to match my text color. It is automatically adjusted to light and dark. And that's how easy it is to create a texturized colorful background that automatically adjusts to light and dark mode with Oxygen using OxyProps. This brings this video to an end, and I'll see you in the next video.